Today we are taking a look at Juhann Begarin, high-flying French guard who since the day he emerged was considered by many an NBA level talent. Let's go back and have a look at his beginnings, break down his game and discuss what future might hold for him. Juhann was born in 2002 in French overseas region Guadeloupe. Comes from a basketball background as most of his close family played or coached. His 14 years older big brother Jesse is currently playing in the first league in France Pro A. At the age of 14, Juhann and his family moved to the outskirts of Paris, where he started his journey with a club called CFBB. He emerged in 2018 at FIBA Under 16 European Championships as a very athletically and physically gifted player. Juhann was hard to stop, especially in the open court. He played with a lot of confidence, put on display his finishing ability, presented defensive potential, but also some nice pull-up jumpers. France was on the right track, but in the semi-finals they narrowly lost to Croatia, who later won the whole tournament. Later they were matched against Turkey in a game for bronze medal, but lost 59-82. The following year, individual awards started to rock up for Juhann. First with all-tournament team selection at Adidas Next Generation Tournament in Kaunas, where he led CFBB Paris to a third place, averaging impressive 20 points, 6.5 rebounds, 3.3 assists, 4.3 steals, but also 6 turnovers. Later on in the summer, Juhann was invited to Basketball Without Borders Europe Camp in Riga, where after a very good performance he was recognized with an MVP award. After that, he again jumped in his national uniform to play at under-18s in Volos, Greece. France this time got stopped by Turkey in the quarterfinals, losing 69-64, and in the end finished 5th. That same summer, Juhann left CFBB for a club called Paris Basketball, a newly formed project in 2018 with big and ambitious plans. It's where he currently plays, perfecting his craft in the second French division called Pro B. At the beginning of last year, he was invited to Chicago to take part along top talent from all around the world in Basketball Without Borders Global Camp and was selected to all-tournament team. Since his breakout performance in 2018, he always looked a bit better physically developed than his peers. At the moment, Juhann stands at just over 6'5". He's a strong guard, has nice shoulders, 7-foot wingspan and a good amount of muscle already on his frame. From the physical standpoint, he definitely looks like he's ready to make a jump to the next level. Juhann is primarily known for his ability to get downhill with the ball. He's fast and runs the floor with long strides. Has a decent, maybe still a bit loose at times, but improved dribble, with nice rhythm and pretty good change of direction, allowing him to get rid of his man in the open court. Take a look at this play. 4 seconds left in the quarter, gets the ball, goes left, quickly crosses over to his right, and glides to the basket for as cool as the other side of the pillow finish to beat the clock. He navigates well and finds his way in between opponents in the open court. Even when defense really jumps on him, he can swiftly squeeze through tight gaps. Juhann can share the ball on the move on a short distance with his teammates, getting a large number of his assists in fast breaks. After rebound or steal, he fills the lane almost instantly and creates passing angles. In half court, Juhann can blow by his men fairly easily going either way, thanks to an explosive first step, and takes full advantage of the lane. Once he gets inside, Juan's a pretty good finisher around the rim. Flies on altitudes, which don't make defenders' life easy trying to disrupt his shot. If you're not careful enough, you will end up on the poster. Has a decent touch inside, sometimes even showing some nice flashes of finesse in his finishing ability, but this area still requires more work, especially his left hand. He is confident driving that way, but when he can't create enough separation and doesn't have a clear way to the basket for a left-handed finish, he will sometimes change to his dominant hand mid-air, forcing some of his shots. Juhann's an okay contact finisher, already pretty strong for a guard, and once he adds even more muscle onto his frame, that will further improve. Can handle some physicality on the way to the basket or in the air, but instead of looking for contact, he at times prefers to dodge bodies and hands, thanks to good body control. Being an aggressive slasher, he does find his way to the line every so often, averages around 4.5 free throws in 25 minutes per game, but Juhann could easily increase that number and get to the line more often if he starts looking to draw more of that contact in the air instead of avoiding it and selling it a bit better on his drives. Juhann has a pretty limited vision, usually to what is in front of him, not seeing a lot peripherally. He's not a very talented passer, careless at times, turnover prone. Some of his passes are very telegraphed and obvious for the defender. Gambles a lot trying to deliver the ball into risky areas, which explains his 2.8 turnovers per game, even though he doesn't even handle the ball that much. When he tries to make plays for others, his deliveries are sometimes a bit late, and teammates lose that split second to get the shot off. Like mentioned before, he can share the ball in transition on a short distance, will give that extra pass to a better positioned teammate on perimeter, see sometimes corner get open on the drive or dump the ball off to the screener on the roll, but it's not a player that will repeatedly make plays for others. Also, his decision making needs to be improved. Take a look at this. He fakes the pass, has a wide open middle, but decides to dish it to the corner while opponent is cutting through the line. Here he timed his drive poorly, started going right while his teammate's defender was still inside, in line of his drive, and almost dribbled himself into a double team. Juhann is not very active off ball, generally stands around and watches what other players are doing, not often enough moving along the perimeter looking for positions, and hardly ever cutting inside. Too often finds himself hovering 25 feet away from the basket, being more of an observer rather than a participant. He sometimes gets to positions too slowly, wastes time and shrinks the floor for his teammates. He needs to find a way to be more productive when he doesn't have the ball in his hands, like he does here. Stays active looking for a better angle if his teammates would want to dish out, or try to cut inside. Unfortunately, plays like that are not a big part of his game at the moment. When it comes to Juhann's shooting ability, he came out strong in his first big youth tournament in 2018, shooting 41% on 39 attempts from deep, but since then he hasn't been able to perform on that level again. In 2019-20 season, in 25 games he had 30% on 37 attempts. This season, as of recording of this episode, he has taken 49 shots, hitting below average 25% of them. Majority of his attempts this season come from stationary position, but he can also sometimes pull off the dribble after screens or little one-on-one, but has even worse results. His motion looks pretty good, has a nice arc, but it's not very quick. Look how low he brings the ball down, dropping it to his knees. Also, he has a somewhat stiff wrist, which might be the culprit behind his inaccuracy. This is also visible when he's at the line, where he hasn't been a good shooter either, usually around 60%. Although improved, Juhann's shot selection still needs more work. His mid-range contested jumpers will drive any coach crazy, and I haven't even seen him hit one this season. Also, he at times really stretches his range. Although Juhann has a very lofty potential on this end of the floor, he's not as good defensively at the moment as his impressive tools and body would suggest. He's not very locked in and is sluggish at times, has quickness to keep his men in front, but leans too much forward sometimes, doesn't take the best angles, and focuses too much on steals, ending up losing position on perimeter too easily. Has a hard time trying to stay attached when the opponent spins or fakes. Despite that, some glimpses of potential when playing aggressive on-ball defense give a lot to be excited for in the future. Has a good low position here, moves his feet well, stays glued all the way and contests tightly with his hands up. Ball bounces off his arms, opponent desperately tries to get a shot off as the clock runs out and gets rejected. Even when he does get beaten, tries to fight back and sometimes manages to stop his man at the rim with a block from behind. I notice he at times, after playing initially solid tight defense, will get his hands tangled up with opponent while trying to contest and gets called for silly fouls. Has pretty active hands, especially in the passing lane starting breaks. But in his defensive stance, Juhann could keep him a bit higher, making full use of his tools like he does when he is contesting shots. Another area where his length comes in handy is transition defense, chasing down opponents. Juhann struggles on screens, his footwork's not the best and doesn't anticipate them well, often bumps right into the screener. Here he sees the screen coming, tries to get over it before his man even made a move yet. Although Juhann visibly improved his defensive awareness, he still has long ways to go. Not always fully alert off ball, walks around, focuses too much on ball and on steals. Often loses sight of his man, which sometimes leads to backdoor cuts or open shots, as he doesn't know where to close out. Here he doesn't have a clue where his man is, allows him to cut inside and get an offensive rebound. Even when he does check on his man, it's not often enough. Late reaction has to trail half a step behind him. From time to time when engaged, he can timely rotate and get in line with his hands up. But then he at times has rather questionable ones, making some really strange moves and positional mistakes. Sometimes gets lost in traffic and takes a while to get back to his man. Can't close out quick enough and gives up a three-pointer here. Thanks to his atomic athleticism and length, Juhann can have an impact on the glass and convert rebounds to fast breaks, but he doesn't always read the ball well and jumps too early. He also occasionally leaks out a bit too early, rarely boxes out or checks on his opponent, which sometimes after offensive rebounds results again in open shots or penetrations after poor closeout. Juhann is often compared to Russell Westbrook, mainly because of how similar their transition game is, but other aspects are not so comparable. Better match in my opinion would be Hamidou Diallo, with Westbrook's ability to get downhill added to the mix. Diallo, apart from being a better off-ball player, has a pretty similar game, struggling to stay consistent as a shooter and also had some rough edges as a defender when he entered the league. Physically, apart from Diallo's slightly bigger frame, they have almost identical profile. I believe Juhann could make similar strides to those Diallo made on defense, and if he also improves his understanding of the game on both ends of the floor, he could be something of a two-way slasher off the bench in the future. As we conclude this video, Juhann is an intriguing player with all the tools you look for physically, but he is a bit of a long-term prospect that requires a lot of work to unleash his potential and to become a contributor on the highest levels.